Hello. In this short video tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to transfer encrypted data files to and from Salesforce Marketing Cloud. Automation Studio in Marketing Cloud enables file transfer and ETL, or extract, transform, and load processing of data files. In our first scenario, we'll use Automation Studio to import an encrypted data file into the platform and store the decrypted data as records in a data extension. Before we can import our file, we'll first need to encrypt it, so let's get started. I'm using GPG Suite, which is open source software that enables you to encrypt and decrypt GPG files. GPG and PGP are almost identical, with a major difference between them being how they're licensed to the public. Now, I've created a CSV file with some sample data and a corresponding data extension where I want to import my data. To encrypt the file, we're going to need the public PGP key for Marketing Cloud, which you can obtain from this URL. I'll now run the following command on my computer to encrypt that data file using the public PGP key. Let's now build an automation to receive our data file when it's imported into our Marketing Cloud SFTP account. We'll start by creating a new automation with a file drop source. Next, we need to configure the source and choose whether to look for a specific file name pattern. In this case, our file name contains the string new member data, so I'll select this option and enter this value in this field. Next, we'll choose the folder where the file is imported into, and we're done. Now, I need to add a couple of activities to our automation canvas. So firstly, we'll drag the file transfer activity to step one, and I'll choose to create a new file transfer activity, and we'll give it a name. We'll select Manage File, and click Next. In this next step, we define the actual file name that will be uploaded. An additional string will be appended to our file name. So, as we don't know the actual file name, I can use the following substitution string to look for the file name that's been uploaded to our watched FTP directory. Next, we'll choose the location where the file has been uploaded to, and choose to decrypt the file. Now, I'll just click Next and finish. By default, files are decrypted in the SFTP import directory. If you observe that files are being decrypted in the import directory, then open a support case and request that encrypted files are decrypted in the safehouse. Alternatively, you can request for the safehouse to be the default destination for all imports. Now, we need to add one file activity to import our file from the safehouse location into a data extension. So we'll drag the import file activity to step two and create a new import definition. We'll add a descriptive name, and in the next step, we'll set the file location to the safehouse. Now, the file that we previously uploaded will be decrypted by the previous activity, so the original file name will have changed, but we can use this substitution string to return the file name without the final .gpg file extension. We'll click Next, and choose the data extension to import the file into. We'll click Next again, and choose an action. In this case, we only want to append new records. As our data file contains file name headings that match the data extension field names, we can leave the Map by Header Row selected and click Next and finish. All we need to do now is to name our automation. save it, and activate it. When I move the encrypted data file to the designated SFTP directory, the automation will run, and we can monitor the progress of our automation by choosing the Activity tab and refreshing the status. We can see this automation is now completed, and if we view our data extension, we can see the encrypted file has been decrypted successfully, and our records are now imported into our data extension. In our next scenario, we'll export data from a data extension and transfer it into our Marketing Cloud SFTP account as an encrypted file. Before we do, we first need to add our public PGP or GPG key file into Marketing Cloud. From the Setup page, open Key Management and create a new key. Set the key type as asymmetric, provide a descriptive name, and upload your public PGP or GPG key, and click Save. Now, we can build an automation to extract the data from a data extension to a PGP file. We'll start by creating a new scheduled automation in Automation Studio. Next, we'll use the data extract activity to extract the data to our safehouse. I'll drag the extract activity to the canvas and click Choose, and click the Create New Data Extract Activity button. We'll name this activity and define the file name pattern that we want to use. In this scenario, let's use member data and suffix the file name with the current date, as we'll run this automation daily. We'll set the extract type as Data Extension Extract, and click Next. As our data is comma delimited, I'll leave the default delimiter as comma and obtain the external key of our target data extension. I'll paste it in this field, now click Next, and finish. Next, we'll use the file transfer activity to move the CSV file from the safehouse to a file location as an encrypted file. I'll click Choose, and then create a new file transfer activity and give it a name, and choose the Move a file from safehouse option, and then click Next. In the file naming pattern, we'll enter the same pattern that we used in the data extract activity. Then set our export destination to the one that's previously been defined as a file location from the setup page. Now, I've created a file location named Local Export, where the location type is set to Enhanced FTP Site Export Directory, so I'll choose that. We now have an option to encrypt the file. Select the Encrypt File option and define the encryption type, either PGP or GPG. In our scenario, we're using GPG. Finally, I'll choose the public key that we created earlier, click Next, and finish. Our automation is now ready to run. We'll name the automation, and before defining a recurring schedule, we'll test it by saving the automation and clicking Run Once. We'll choose to run all the activities in the automation and then click Run. Now, we can monitor the progress of our automation by choosing the Activity tab and refreshing the status. We can see that our automation has been completed successfully, and the encrypted file has been transferred to our file location, which I can now download and decrypt locally using the associated private key. I can now modify the automation schedule to run at the desired frequency. Perhaps daily at midnight. I'll click Done, I'll save it, change the schedule to active and activate. Using file encryption in Salesforce Marketing Cloud, together with an appropriate file transfer protocol and organizational security policies, will help protect your customers' data. For more tips, please subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/cloudkettle and sign up for our newsletter at cloudkettle.com.